Well, hello, my name is Eden Hunt. Like I said earlier, I'm from Beckley, West Virginia. This is my second summer working at some of our students' camp, so I'm really excited to be here and be back in this church. First, I want to say thank you, Pastor, just for allowing us to come back. I know a lot of times Dr. Evans will talk to us, he's like, you know, be an encouragement to the people, but so many times we come here, and it's like, you guys are more of an encouragement to us, and feel like then we can be to you all. I'll start with my salvation testimony. When I was 7 years old, I trusted Christ as my personal Savior. I remember hearing the verse, it's in Romans 6:23. It says, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. And that word death, it really scared me. And I was like, you know, I don't want to die and go to hell. And I remember when I was 7, I put my faith and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. And that was the greatest decision I ever made in my life. And I just want to encourage any of you all that, you know, and you haven't put your faith and trust in the Lord, just do that before it's too late. You know, just like you were saying earlier, you know, just one more soul, it will be worth it all. That's why we're here. You know, that's why we do camp, because it's worth it all for just one more young person, one more even, you know, counselor, just to trust Christ. But as I got older, when I was young, my parents were separated, and so I grew up in a broken home, and you know, here and there, here everywhere, like different things, and through different circumstances with, you know, family situation, I became very bitter towards God, towards, you know, my dad and things like that. And honestly, bitterness eats you alive. It's like one of the worst things that can happen to someone. It'll eat you alive. And I remember when I was young, on the outside, I mean, I'd go to master club or study school and I was fine. You know, I'd go to teen group and I'd act okay. But on the inside, you know, I was so dark. And I was so dark on the inside of bitterness. And I remember it truly did just eat me alive. I remember when I was 16 years old, I know, like I said a little bit ago, you know, salvation was the greatest decision I ever made. But other than that, one thing in my Christian life that was a turning point for me is when I gave God that bitterness. And I remember I was in a service, it was a youth meeting, and the speaker and I, you know, I was telling a friend last night how vital this, like, quote, I love quotes, and my friends make fun of me because how much I love them, but how vital this little quote was in my life. And so I always like to share it wherever I go, but it says, bitterness is like drinking poison and waiting on another person to die. And I realized that's what I was doing. I was waiting, you know, through the second circumstance. I had the most blessed life, but yet I was the one bitter and being eaten up by that bitterness. And I just decided I would give it to God, and I asked God to take that away from me. And that was one of the best decisions other than salvation I made in my Christian walk. And through that, through the circumstances and through that decision, the Lord led me to Crown College. I am going to be a senior this year, so it's kind of hard to believe it's finally coming to an end. I plan to get my master's, but that's just, you know, that's in the future, and hopefully I'll be getting married. So I am, but hopefully, hopefully, you know. But the Lord's so good, and you know, honestly, coming into working another summer, I was kind of hesitant towards it. You know, you have Richard, who's been here 3 summers, and some of us have been back in Sephora. She was there with 3 summers, 4. And so I was kind of hesitant toward it, but you know, honestly, the Lord is already blessed, and I see how long I was being hesitant. My friend, one of my best friends, she told me, anything you do for the Lord is not going to be in vain. Yeah. And I already see that. And I'm so thankful just to be here again. I never thought I would actually see this church again, but I'm so thankful to be here, and I thank you for having us. And one verse that we knew, and we find it really fast, is it's actually my grandpa's life verse, but I've kind of, you know, kind of claiming it too, but it's Romans 8:28. It says, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose. Amen. And so just hold on to that, and if there are any of you that are better or maybe you're unsaved, try to get that taken care of, of course.